Welcome back. In the previous videos, we have studied that the electric field at any point, it can be obtained by calculating the force at a test charge and by dividing the force by the magnitude of this test charge, we can obtain the magnitude of the electric field. And if the test charge is positive, so the direction of the force in a positive test charge would be the same as the direction of the electric field. The question now is, assume that we know we have some electric field around us and we want to find out the total force at a specific point of charge. So in calculating the electric field, we said that the electric field is the force over the magnitude of the tested charge over Q naught. So F over Q naught, it was the value of the electric field. Now, if I have the electric field and I have Q, I can say that the force on the charge equals Q multiplied by the electric field. As an example, assume that we have an electron and we have electric field directed in X direction. If I say the electric field is directed in X direction, it means that if I have a positive charge, the force in this positive charge, it would be directed in X direction. So, the force on a negative charge, it would be directed in negative X direction. So, the force equals Q with its sign multiplied by the electric field. So, if the charge is negative, the force will be in the negative direction to the direction of the electric field. Alright? Okay. So, in this figure, what is the direction of the electrostatic force on the electron due to external field? So, the electron is a negative charge. So, the direction of the force on the electron, in this case, it would be the opposite to the direction of the electric field. The direction of the electric field in positive x, so the direction of the force on the electron would be in negative x. Right? Okay. In which direction will the electron accelerate if it is moving parallel to the y axis before it encounters it in the external electric field? Assume that the electric field here and the electron was moving parallel to the y direction, and while moving toward the y direction, it passed by the region of the electric field. So the question is, what will be the direction of the acceleration of the electron in this case? Effectively, if I am moving in y direction and the force due to the electric field in negative x direction, so the velocity of the electron in y direction will not be affected. But due to the force in negative x direction, there will be some acceleration in negative x direction, because we know that the mechanical force equals the mass of the body multiplied by its acceleration. So the force induced by the electric field on the electron will induce acceleration in the direction of this force. So the acceleration, it would be in negative x direction. This means that the electron will be moving in positive y direction with a constant velocity, and we will have some acceleration in the velocity in negative x direction. It means that it will move something like an arc in this way. In which direction will the electron accelerate if moving parallel to the y axis before encounter the external field? If instead the electron is initially moving rightward, it means that the electron was moving in positive x direction. If the electron was moving in positive x direction and it has encountered such electric field, so this electric field will introduce a force on the electron in negative x direction. In this case, the electron will have deacceleration or acceleration in negative x direction. So if I assume that the electron will moving with a constant velocity Vx entering the electric field, then we have an acceleration in negative x, means that the velocity in positive x will be decreased as long as I'm moving in positive x until it will reach zero. After reaching zero, the acceleration will make the electron move back in negative x direction. So if instead the electron initially moving rightward, it will speed increase or decrease or remain constant. It will decrease. Decrease why? Because it was moving against the force. So if it's moving against the force will introduce acceleration in the negative direction. So it will decrease the velocity. Okay? As a numerical example, let us assume that we have a point of charge. We have an ink drop with a mass m equals 1.3 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 10 kilograms, and has a negative charge. The magnitude of the charge is 1.5 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 13 coulombs. So this is negative, so Q is minus 1.5. This is the magnitude and the charge is negative. The charge enters the region between two plates, these two plates, initially moving in x-axis. So initially it was moving in x-axis with a constant speed Vx equals 18 meter per second. So the velocity in x direction, it was 18 meter per second. And the length of the two plates is 1.6 centimeters. The plates are charged and thus produce electric field. If we have a charge, we have electric field. And the electric field at all points between the two plates is constant, and assume that the electric field is downward directed in uniform. So assume that the electric field in all the region between the two plates and directed downward. So it is going from positive y to negative y in this direction, right? And the magnitude of the electric field is 1.4 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 Newton per coulomb. It is required to determine what is the vertical deflection of the drop at the far edge of the plane. At the beginning, what will make this drop or this ink drop to be deflected in y direction? Actually, the drop is moving with a constant velocity along x direction. However, this drop has a force in y direction due to the electric field in y direction. And the direction of the electric field is going from positive y to negative y, and the charge itself is negative. This means that the force due to the electric field on the charge equals Q multiplied by E. The force on the point of charge due to the electric field equals Q multiplied by E. And because Q is negative, the direction of this force will be in the negative direction to the E. This means that the direction of the force, it would be in the direction of positive y, not in the negative y. Alright? Okay. So, we have a force in the particle. This force will introduce acceleration, and this acceleration would be in the direction of the force. So, we have acceleration in y direction. So, actually, we start the velocity pure x direction. We don't have velocity in x in y direction, but due to the acceleration, which is due to the force on the particle, we will have a velocity or acceleration in y direction. This velocity in y direction will deflect the bus from going in x direction to be some in x direction and some in y direction. The question now is, this force is extending along the blade. So as long as I am moving along the blade, we have this force. What will be the distance or the deflecting along the y direction? This is our question. So our question now is, what is the vertical deflection of the drop at the far edge of the plate? Assuming that the gravitational force is negligible with respect to the electrical force. So we are going to neglect the gravitational force, or what is called M multiplied by G going downward. It will be negligible with respect to the electrical force. So to calculate this, we start with the calculation of the force on the charged particle. The force on the charged particle, it would be the magnitude of the charge multiplied by the electric field, Q multiplied by E. And its direction, as we said, Q is negative and the electric field is going in negative Y, so negative by negative, so the direction of the force, it would be in positive Y. And according to this force, we can calculate the acceleration in the y direction as the magnitude of the force over the mass of the particle. So the acceleration in y direction would be q multiplied by e over the mass of the particle. Now, if you are interested to find out the distance y after time t by using the acceleration, going back to the laws of mechanics, we can find the distance in terms of the acceleration as a function of time as y equals half the acceleration, ay, multiplied by t squared, where t is a time. But which time? It is required to find the deflection when the particle moves from the starting of the blade to the end of the blade. And effectively, this time is governed by the velocity along the x-axis, because it is moving with a constant velocity along the x-axis. So the length L will be passed after a time equals the velocity along the x-axis multiplied by the time t. Or in other words, the total deflection will be obtained after time equals L over Vx. Now, by combining these pieces together, we can say that the deflection distance y equals 1 over 2 multiplied by the acceleration in y direction, which is q multiplied by the electric field over m, q multiplied by the electric field over m, multiplied by the time squared, and the time is L over Vx, so L squared over Vx squared. The value of the charge, it was 1.3 multiplied by 10 to the power minus, 1.5 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 13 coulomb. And already we have taken into consideration the negative sign in the direction of what? Alright? So, we are going to take the magnitude of the charge. The value of the electric field, it was 1.4 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 Newton per coulomb. 1.4 multiplied by 10 to the power 6 Newton per coulomb. The length of the blade L, is 1.6 centimeters. We are going to convert it to SI units, so it would be 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2, because 1 centimeter is 1 over 100 of meter. So this would be 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2. 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2. Over 2m multiplied by Vx. 2, the mass of the particle. It was 1.3 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 10 kilograms. And the velocity Vx, it was 18 meter per second. 18 meter per second. By calculating this, we can find out the deflection of y after passing through the plate. It would be 6.4 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4 meters, which can be represented in terms of millimeters as 0.64 millimeters. Okay? Alright.